everyone. Today we're going to talk about one of the churches that was built under the Spanish colonial era, which is of course the St. Peter of Alcantara Church in Pakil, Laguna. There are two builders, or rather two maestro de obra for the church. First of course is Padre Francisco Barajas, who ordered the church to be built in bamboo and nipa in 1676. The second one is Padre Fernando Haro, who ordered the church to be built in stone in 1732. The church was completely finished in 1767. However, because of the tower, it was extended until 1777. A little fun fact, the Turumba Festival is the longest and largest religious festival in our country, which is of course the Philippines. And it was created because of this church and the paintings of Our Lady of Sorrow. A little history time about the St. Peter of Alcantara Church. In 1676, construction was made from bamboo and nipa by Padre Francisco Barajas with the patronage of San Pedro de Alcantara when Pakil separated from Paete. In 1732, the construction of the stone convent and church was ordered by Padre Fernando Haro. However, in 1739, it was burned and damaged by fire. Though in 1767, it was completely repaired and finished. However, in 1788, it got destroyed again by a fire. Though eventually, in 1851, it was reconstructed by Padre Juan de Llarena. Unfortunately, in 1881, it was destroyed by an earthquake which destroyed the tower and the roof of the church. It was then reconstructed again in 1881 by Padre Juan de Dio Villayos. In 1883, the ceiling and altar was installed by Padre Pauline Camba. And in that same year, it was again destroyed by another earthquake. It was again rebuilt in 1937 by Padre Federico Diaz Pines with the help of the Confederation of United Catholics. And in 1959, the altar was made into marble by Padre Joseph Regan and was consecrated by Bishop Alejandro Olaila. Finally, in 1980 to 1984, the tower and ceiling was reconstructed through the management of the Parish Council of the Laity. And that's it for the history of St. Peter of Alcantara Church. And next is, a colleague of mine would be discussing about the ornamentation of the church.
Initially, the St. Peter of Alcantara Church was built out of nipa and bamboo. However, it was destroyed numerous times by fire and damaged by an earthquake in 1937. Now the church is built in bricks, gravel, cement, and sand. The ornamentation of the exterior composes of stone engravings on its cornices and reliefs. On the other hand, the interior has a main retablo, painted in white with statues of 14 saints. The facade is adorned by complex stone engravings and statues. The warm hue comes from the patina that has been weathered throughout time. The church is asymmetrical. It is 49 by 11 meters in a shape resembling a Christian cross. The architectural style is a combination of Corinthian and Ionic orders.
So for the architectural elements, first is the fresco painting which is located on the ceiling near the altar and inside of the church where the model of retablo is located. Next is the retablo or the altar itself. It is mostly made of marble and has 14 statues of saints and Archangel Michael located on top. Next is the Corinthian columns, which shows that it is the inspiration of the style of the church, and its engravings or ornaments that represents the era of Corinthian and Ionic orders. Next is the small courtyard, which is common among churches, where a special statue or structure is located. Lastly is the arch openings and clerestory windows, which finalized the influence of the Corinthian and Ionic period to this church. And that's our presentation about St. Peter of Alcantara Church located in Pakil, Laguna for History of Architecture 4. Thank you and have a nice day.